Hey, what's up guys? Jesse here of MetrolineDirect. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install the Avaya CU360 video conferencing bar. Out of the box, it comes with Android 7, so we're going to upgrade that to Android 10. We're going to install the Google Play Store and install the Zoom app. Hey, if you like the video, do me a favor and click the like button. And if you want to see more videos from us, click the subscribe button. So this is a standalone device that installs on top of a 4K or 1080p resolution monitor. There's no need for a computer, and it comes with this remote. It has a keypad on the back, so you can control it right from the remote on the device, or you can browse to it in a web browser from a separate computer if you'd like. So I've already mentioned we're going to be installing Zoom. You can also install other apps like BlueJeans, Pexip, the Chrome web browser. So you can install it wired with a Cat5 cable or wirelessly with Wi-Fi. If you take a look at the back of the unit, you have your HDMI port that's going to connect to your monitor, Cat5 cable if you choose to use that. Also, I do want to mention, if you are going to be using Bluetooth and Wi-Fi to connect, they do recommend using the 5 GHz Wi-Fi connection. So here's how it sits on top of your monitor. You've got on the bottom here, this swings out. And you just place it on top of the monitor, and then this is going to squeeze it. Basically, squeeze the monitor, and it just sets up on top. Once the unit has booted up, you should come to your home screen. If you're not on your home screen, you can press the home button on your remote. Press the arrow button in the upper left corner of the remote to activate your mouse. And then click on the icon at the bottom that looks like the CU360 on top of a monitor. And you'll see in the upper left corner, the IP address of the unit is behind some other icons that are used for controlling the CU360. The other place you can look is click on Configure, and then select System Status. And you'll see GLAN and the IP address. So you can easily browse to it. Just put that IP address in your web browser, and the default username is admin with a capital A and password 1234. Now ahead of time, you're going to want to go and download the firmware. You're going to want to download the new version from support.avaya.com. Just click on support by product at the top and then click on downloads and then search for CU360. The current release is 11.3. So that's what we're going to be upgrading to today. So you're going to click on Administration Settings at the top, click on Utilities at the left, and then click on Software Update. Here they warn you that it will take a long time. You need to click on Next, and then click the Browse File button. That'll let you browse to the location where you've saved your file. When it's originally downloaded, it will come as a zipped file, so you'll need to unzip it. To do that, right-click on the file and click on Extract All. And it should automatically extract to the same folder, probably your download folder. And you can open up the new folder. Now, this is a two-step process. So first, we're going to choose 11_2_0_23. We'll let that upgrade. And then we'll come back and choose 11_3_0_40. So the upgrade should take about 15 to 20 minutes. And what I found out here is that the unit actually finishes upgrading before this message in the web browser will tell you. If you keep an eye on the CU360 itself, the lights on the front of it will turn red and have a circular pattern to them. So when it stops doing that, that means that the unit is finished upgrading and it should be back online soon, and then you can just refresh your web browser. So then again, we're browsing to the IP address of our CU360, log back in. It looks a bit different this time, but the process is the same. Click on the I agree checkbox, click Next, click on Choose, and choose the file. Here's our second file, and click Upload. Alright guys, so originally I had planned on showing installing the Play Store and installing the Zoom app, but I think this video is running a little bit long, so I'm going to cut it off here and do a part 2 video where I show installing the Play Store and Zoom. So make sure you check that out. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and thanks for watching.